Hello everyone, my name's Ilir2 and welcome to a Let's Try of the Third Age Total War mod for Medieval 2 now. So, I just want to say this at the very beginning. I am not good at Total War games. I'm very, how should I put this, impatient. Very, very impatient and not that good at real-time strategy in general. So, when it comes down to the battles, don't expect much. So, anyways, so if you guys didn't know, the Third Age Total War mod is like an amazing mod built for the Medieval 2, and it puts you in the place of Middle Earth, Lord of the Rings. If you didn't know, it's the Third Age of Middle Earth. Blah blah blah. You get to play. Let's go into single player. Third Age campaign, obviously. You get to play as Gondor, Rohan, Eriador, Dale, High Elves, Woodland Elves, Lothlorien, Dwarves, Mordor, Isengard, Misty Mountain Orcs, Gundabad Orcs, Harad, Rune, and Dunland. Now, I do have a submod in. I forget which submod it is, but it is a submod, so it adds in Dunland and Lothlorien. So if you play just the normal mod, you won't get any of these. But I think I'm just gonna, since this is just a Let's Try, I'm just gonna do Eriador. It's very easy, very basic start, you know, Aragorn and that sort of thing over here with the Hobbits. We're gonna do, doesn't matter, short campaign rules, medium battle, medium difficulty, whatever. Manage all cities, yeah, show CPU moves, and no battle time limit. I hate battle time limits. Anyways, so let's begin. So each race actually gets their own intro too, which, I mean, they put a lot of work into this mod. It's one of the, probably the best mod for Medieval 2, I would say. There's also a Elder Scrolls mod, but let's just skip ahead. Doesn't really matter. But men are better than gates, and no gate will endure against the enemy if men desert it. Gimli, son of Gloin, the last debates. So it's the winter 3008 of the Third Age. I don't really know when everything starts to happen, like the Fellowship of the Ring and stuff. Probably around this time, I would assume, because there is a Fellowship campaign where you actually play as the Fellowship, and you have to, like, strategize, and you have to get, you know, all the way to Mordor and stuff like that. But anyways, so yeah, the submod. What is this? Crap, I forgot which submod this is. So this just adds in Holy Wars, so jihads for the good guys, because the bad guys have invasions. But the good guys can have Tol Arkans. Sure, we'll accept. Earlier invasions, I'm just going to say no. This doesn't really matter. A garrison script adds additional troops in some AI settlements the moment you besiege them. I hate that. Resurrect allied factions. Sure. Diplomacy scripts. Yeah, good guys and evil guys. So basically, I can't ally with orcs, which kind of makes sense. So I'm going to accept that. Mysterious documents, that helps Saruman. Again, doesn't matter of me. Immortal heroes, no, that makes me way too overpowered because I have Aragorn, Gandalf, and Frodo all as leaders, so I'll just have infinite amounts of leaders. It's bad. Counter invasions, to help the good factions, sure. We're not going to get invaded though. Corsairs, I hate that. Reforge Arnor. Now, here's the thing with Eriador, they actually added in an ability to reforge Arnor, which if you didn't know is like a, you know, Kingdom of Man, whatever. You could start off immediately with Arnor and get some like amazing troops and stuff. I'm just gonna say no. Immortal Nazgul. Now this actually makes sense lore-wise, so I'm gonna say yes. Shadow from the East, yeah, he's gathering his forces. I don't really care, don't do that. Diplomatic meetings, sure. The next heir. Alright, cool. So, there in Beckian, written by Bilbo Baggins. It is recommended that that this book will be in the possession of the future heir to the throne in for safekeeping. Alright, so basically, whoever has this book becomes the heir. Spawning additional units. The spawning additional units Elven Rangers submod adds Elven Rangers to the Eriador Arnor faction. Yeah, sure. Total diplomacy, don't care. Enable Sauron's counterattack. Having the diplomatic meetings. Yeah, sure. Again, doesn't matter. We're not going to be playing the whole game. This is just to show it off. So, after all of that, we're finally here with Third Age. Cool. So as you can see, Eriador is quite big. Hobbiton, Bree, Fornos Teheran, Numenas, all the way to Fenestrunin. Drunin? I think that's how you pronounce it. So we have our leaders, Gandalf, yes, here. Lord. And who's this? Halbarad. Where's...
Yes, my lord.
And that's just some random dude. Where is... Aragorn. Oh, you know what? Aragorn is all the way over here, isn't he? Yep. So over here is where the rangers are trained, and we want rangers. We want lots and lots of them. We're going to do a very high tax. Should we?
Yes, my lord.
You know what? I don't want to move Aragorn out without having some rangers on his side. All right. So Deep Hollow is going to be a very good place to attack first because it is a rebel village, after all. So we have the Orcs of Gundabad to the north, the Misty Mountain Orcs to, well, the east, and then we have Dunland to the south. Those would be our three main enemies. Then, of course, we have the High Elves over here, the Dwarves up here, and the High Elves over here as well in Rivendell. So, we probably want to attack Mangalan first. Mangalan. Oh, I'm sorry, not Deep Hollow. We want to attack Mangalan first. I don't know why I said Deep Hollow before. And then we have Weathertop. I forget what it's called. It's Weathertop, though. We have to attack that as well. Should be easy. Up here, we're probably not going to get attacked. Let's see. We have Merchants, Archer Militia, and Lumbermen. Which is better? Well, Lumbermen have a lot more attack, slightly less defense, and they do cost only slightly more. So I think Lumbermen will be the best. Let's just go ahead and grab all these guys, send them down to Bree. Now, Bree's going to be, obviously, is our capital, so that's going to be a very important place to reinforce. Over in Hobbiton, we obviously are going to have lots of hobbits. We have some hobbits down to here as well, right? Well, that's just,
Your orders, my lord.
Paladin. No idea who that is, but whatever. Roramak, and some more hobbits. So, basically, three hobbit towns. And now, okay... If you have the normal mod on, Hobbiton won't be owned by Eriador. It'll be set up as a semi-autonomous state where it constantly gives you hobbits to fight, which doesn't sound good, but it's good, trust me. All right, we'll go ahead and get the Bandobras archers, and Frodo can move out as well.
By your command.
All right. Roramak... He can move to Bree as well. We just want as many good soldiers as possible. What does he have? Hobbit bodyguards. They aren't that good, are they?
Your orders, my lord.
Yeah, their defense is horrible. I mean, compared to the, what are these? The Dunedain bodyguards. Dunedain bodyguards are amazing. And I'm assuming these guys also have Dunedain bodyguards. So we're going to move all these guys down. Ooh, the Rangers. We want those. Greenway Guard and Militia can move down.
Yes.
We have an Eriador spy. Let's send him up north, because there are some rebel villages up here, and of course we're going to have Gundabad eventually come down from the north. I don't know why I'm planning this long. I'm not going to be playing forever. Although on this end of the world, we might want to actually expand over here, because there are some elven rebels that we can take over.
Your order,
so, I think I'm going to take the Hobbitry in Arms and the Hobbit dude over. This guy, I mean, he has nothing here. Kind of sucks. Really kind of sucks there, bud. Get Breland Militia there. That would be good. Hobbiton, we've already, you know, just move. Do we have any archers? We don't.
Your will, my lord.
The Hobbits in Arms.
Yes.
Move them out.
My lord.
And, you know, just stay in there for now. Deep Hollow, I think you're good. Oh, you know what I should have been doing? I should
orders.
Be setting up
orders, my lord.
Watchtowers.
This tower,
those
my
are
lord.
Definitely important. I will say.
Yes, my lord.
Quite important indeed.
This
and there you go. So we
be
have view on all
the
roads. Cool.
Camp here.
And that should be good. All right, let's actually end the turn. An insane turn at that. Insane in the membrane. Insane in the brain. Hilarious, I know. Absolutely hilarious. Alright, so... Gondor, come on, Lothlorien, Mordor. Isengard. Dun Lint. Misty Mountain Orcs. Gundabad. Harad, Enrun. Enrun, there you go. And then we have good old Sauron. Now, Sauron is kind of weird because he's the Pope of his own, like, religion, obviously. And he can call down invasions, which are basically crusades. Whatever. Alright, so the bride, yep. Always. I don't know why you would ever say no to that. A quest for a hero. Chieftain Aragorn, these dark times live. Oh. The Nine have left Minas Morgul and are now traveling west across the lands as we speak. Storm is coming and we should be prepared. It would be best if you travel to the city of Bree in order to acquire information about all that has happened. So I guess it kind of gives you, quests? Yeah. The Palantiri? Yeah, only, obviously Barad-dûr, Isengard, and Mithlond have it. That basically gives you, the ability to see all the other Palantir. I think that's what it does. Whatever. Retinue expands. Gandalf, King Aragorn, and more King Aragorn. Lord Arathor gets married. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you. And you guys continue on.
We can go
no ahead, build that watchtower,
this
boys.
Tower will keep vigil over the lands.
And you guys down here.
Orders.
You have many archers?
Yes, my lord.
Yeah, you do. Fuck it, get some more.
As you wish. Orders.
Whatever, it's good. Alright, everyone go down to Bree. And you... Oh, I thought you were training. Oh, you are. What if we just left this open?
Lord.
That would be a horrible idea. Well, with very high taxes, it would be a horrible idea. Let's just set it to low taxes.
Your orders.
We're going to set up a watchtower here as well.
This tower will keep vigil over the lands.
We want to make sure, because this
honor.
Is the Misty Mountain Orcs. Right on this line, and we do not want them capturing that land. Oh,
yes, my lord.
Where the fuck did that? Yes. There's so many guys just sitting around doing nothing. Like, where the fuck did you even come from? Whatever. We'll leave some Breeland militia there, and we'll go ahead and attack.
We shall prevail.
Finally, all right. Let's go ahead and assault. Now these are orcs. They're all orc looters. Now, from what I can attest, that these. The AI in this game isn't always the best. Let's go ahead and begin an actual attack. So you can actually just stay on the outskirts of the town and just blast them with arrows, you know, and they'll all die before they even get close to you. It's pretty great. All right. And here we are. Oh, it's winter. Oh boy. Start the deployment. So we're going to set up cavalry for all these guys. So much cavalry, but you know, I'm risking quite a bit to have this entire army here. And then you guys unite as well. All right, so these rangers are insane. The range on them is huge. It's fantastic. So let's set them up like that. I'm assuming they don't like the fact that the hobbits are there, so it's kind of freaking out on me. Keep that there, and all of you guys. Maybe I'll split you in half. You guys come here, create your own group, and then you guys on the other end will flank them. So we'll have a bunch of flanks coming in. We'll start, and we'll begin by moving in our archers. We want them to get this close. That should be all right. Now, you guys actually have to loop around over here. So, get over here. And then these guys, I guess we'll just move up here. Can you get into, like, smaller groups like this, please and thank you? All right, cool. Everyone move out. We won't run because that's kind of a waste. It looks as though they're all just kind of getting closer together. Yeah, they're all just trying to defend the town center. Can the Dunedain archers reach them? Come on. Speed it up a bit. No, they cannot. All right, great. Get a bit closer. And then the rest of you, I'm sorry, you and you, go up here. And then the hobbits stay in the back. Oh, I think they're freaking out. Yeah, they're freaking out because I'm surrounding them. Alright, now you should be able to hit them. Yes, there you go. Alright, see? Look at that range on the Dunedain archers. Quite insane, I'd like to say. And there they go. Sweet. So if we just turn this up all the way, full speed, it gets pretty insane. Watch this. They probably won't even be able to get through. Or maybe they will, who knows. With all these archers firing at them, slow it down a bit. Yeah, they might just freak out. The AI just doesn't know what to do for some reason. It says, all right, we gotta run and attack. But then it's like, wait a second. We're getting destroyed here. And then they don't move anyone else out. It's pretty insane. All right, but skirmish mode is on, so they might start running. Nope. Nope, we've routed this entire group. They've just totally failed there. And this is how you destroy an entire orc army without losing a single man. And then they'll send out the next group, and they'll all get slaughtered. Let's see. Yep, they just stop for some reason. Again, I don't know, the AI is just weird. Come on, get closer, it's easier to kill you that way. And they all run away with only like 50 troops left. Not even 50. It's way less. So then we start attacking others that are deeper in, and oh look, they're about to send out a whole nother group. Thank you, Dunedain archers. Because what happens is the Dunedain archer starts hitting them. That causes the AI to freak out and start attacking you. But then they get too close and you have like hundreds of arrows flying at you, so they lose most of their army, which causes them to freak out again. Oh, are they actually gonna make it? Hey, they actually made it. Sweet. All right, well, go ahead and rush in. Rush in. And all these, I'm sorry. I want all, damn it, these and these. These are all just missile troops. All of you start rushing in. All right, and the archers need to get the fuck out. So everyone run.
The battle is very much in our favor. Victory will
and
be
you
ours.
Guys gotta charge. Everyone charge forward. You don't just walk. How lame. What are you doing? Oh, they've decided, oh yeah, no, we're gonna go around this way and not this way. Whatever. Stay out. Oh no, they're firing missiles. Shit, I shouldn't have told them to stay out. Well, hopefully none of them die. They'll move in.
The enemy are badly bloodied.
Just move forward, all of you. Yep, okay, we've pushed them back. And there goes their general. Or I guess captain. You don't fire at will and stop whatever you're doing. We're just going to close in on the enemy here. These are all just our archers, so they don't matter at all. We're easily killing them. And they're orcs, so they're not, like, the most powerful in the world. Yeah. There they go. Hopefully we don't lose anyone important. Like Gandalf. Oh, that would suck, wouldn't it? I'm surprised we aren't capturing the... There we go.
Command of the city.
Capture the city, and doesn't matter because we've already killed them all.
By the victory,
so we've lost 46. They lost 1,261. That's a bit of an exploit, I'd say. Bit of an exploit. Oh, hey, Iron Wolf. Iron Wolf is playing U4. Cool. That's great. So, now, this is not really much else to do. This ledge try. I guess we'll just conquer the city.
We have triumphed!
Occupy. Not the city, it's a village.
Our courage and
so
honor
tiny.
Have conquered.
Yeah, I don't really care. Ooh, Barrow Downs. Oh, this is where the Barrow Downs are. Right. Can't destroy it. Yeah, stupid haunted crypts. Crypts?
Yes, my lord.
I can't move him forward anymore. Halbarad is an aspiring commander. Enemy routes. Cool.
Your
so let's
orders,
just
my lord.
Merge all the troops.
Your will, my orders.
You guys are moving
yes,
forward. Great. There you go. Another turn. Hooray. Hurrah, hurrah. Hooray, hooray. Gondor always taking forever. Just because you're fighting the Dark Lord doesn't mean you can take forever, Gondor. Jesus Christ. Same with you, Mordor. Oh my god, why are they taking so long? It's the beginning of the game. It should only take like 5 seconds. I guess in a normal game, it would only take 5 seconds because, well, you only have like 2 cities each. But in this mod, everyone has like 12 cities. There are so many regions in this mod, too. It's insane. Oh. I think I just saw some, a rebel army pop up. It should be fine.
Right.
Right. Here's the road. Making I'm gonna go that way. My lord. Cool. Alright, well, you know what? This is where I'm gonna have to end this let's try. Just showing off the mod. You know, I'm just gonna save the game here. I'm just gonna save the game. Just in case, you know? And let's go ahead and toggle F-O-W. Just to show off this world. By the way, if you go all the way up here. Oh, hey, there's Sauron. I believe that's... No, that's just a servant of Sauron. And then there's this big area. Forodwaith. It's weird. You can't ever get to it because it's in the mountains. So it's impossible to get to. But you have places like Mordor, Isbarador, Harad. Which, I mean, look at how big Harad starts off. All this gray. These are just rebels. It's kind of insane how many rebel places there are. But look at that. So we have the dwarves and high elves in these areas. They need to take over a bit of land. It's great. And I'm just in the middle of all this gray. Then you have Gondor, Rohan, Isengard. And by the way, a lot of these lands, like Isengard, the Hornburg, Barad-dûr, the Black Gate, Minas Morgul, a lot of these important places actually have customized maps. So like Mengallen, you saw, was just a village. There's nothing important. Yeah, Amansul. That's what Rivertop is. Weathertop, not Rivertop. Whatever. But so if you guys want to see more of this mod, go ahead and tell me in the comments. And if you guys want to see any other game, tell me that as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Ilir2, and I'll see you guys in the next Let's Try. Goodbye.